मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ विनय त्रिपाठी, वेलकम टू योर ऑनलाइन क्लास। सी स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज योर एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज पार्ट वन टेक्स्ट बुक ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 5। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू इन ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर 11, आवर होम एंड एनवायरमेंट। सी स्टूडेंट्स, प्रीवियस चैप्टर 10 वी हैव लर्न गेटिंग टू नो इंडिया, ओके? सो ट्राई दिस। सो सी स्टूडेंट्स, सो मेनी हाउसेस पिक्चर्स आर शोन इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक, कैन यू सी दैट? ओके, so think of your environment and the climate there and choose the most suitable house for yourself by putting a right tick mark in the box near the picture. Okay students, so you have to make put tick mark near the houses. Now see that on the way to your school or market or when you travel to another town, you see many things. Okay students, so observe carefully the houses that you see. Note the construction shape, building materials and other aspects of the different houses. Do some of the houses resemble the specimens shown above? So see students, some questions are given here. First question is, what materials are used for building houses? See students, so that means it is totally activity based. So what types of material are used? See students, materials such as brick, cements, iron, wood, water, okay, that means sand, floor tiles, all these things are used for building houses. Okay students, next one is, compare any two types of houses that you saw and note down the difference. So see students, that means how generally houses in village are built by using materials like brick, roof tiles or tin sheets, etc. And see students, houses in cities are built by using materials like brick, cement, iron, floor tiles, sand, roof tiles, etc. Okay, so these are differences are there. Now third one is, what are different things from which a house give us protection? So see students, you all know that a house protects us from the sun, the wind, the cold and the rain, okay? So it also protects us from wild animals and keep us safe from antisocial elements, okay students? Fourth one is, in what way are the houses A, B and C different? Which of them appear to be the safest? So see the pictures A, B and C, the three houses are shown here, okay students? So see students, the houses A is made up of clay and mud, can you see that? And the houses B is made up of leaves and stick, see? As a student, the houses C is made up of cement, brick, roof tiles, okay? And this way, according to these houses, students, the house C appear to be the safest, okay students? Now next one is, see that which of the above houses are mainly seen in cities and which are seen mainly in the rural areas? So see students, that means six pictures are shown here, A, B, C, D, E, F, okay? So according to this picture, the houses D, E and F are mainly seen in cities. See the picture, okay? And students, the houses A, B and C are mainly seen in the rural area, that means in the village, okay? So this way, according to this, you have to, let me see the sixth question. Think about your own environment and the climate there and choose the most suitable house for yourself, putting a right tick mark in the box near the picture. Already I told you, so that means you have to make right tick mark in the box near the picture, okay students? For different type of houses in the picture, okay students, their main uses can be listed as follows. Why we can build the houses and what are their main uses are the students? So first one is shelter, okay? Second one is a resting place, we can take the rest in the house. Third point is protection against the sun, the wind, the cold and the rain, okay? Our house will protect us against the sun, the wind, the cold and the rain, okay students? And fourth point is protection from wild animals. So when we are in our home, so we will, that means we are safe. And this way house, our house protect us, that means it will protect from wild animals, okay? So this way houses are very important to us. Last point is keeping ourselves safe from anti-social elements. So see students, all these are their main uses are there. So their list is given below, okay students? Make friend with map. See students, so this is your India map, major regions and type of houses. So see students, that means which place, what types of houses are built, the picture shown here. See that desert place, these type of houses are there. In mountainous place, how they make build the houses, okay? Plain area, see that these type of houses are there. And see that region of medium rainfall, these type of houses are there. And see students, which place heavy rainfalls are there, these types of houses are there. sloping roof. Okay, can you see that? And low rainfall, these are houses are there. I see this, that means which place heavy rainfall, see the house slopings, houses are slopings are there. So this way, these type of houses are built in different place according to their reason wise. Now see students, the above figures show a map of India and the types of houses that are common in the respective regions. Okay, since ancient times, note how the construction or structure of the houses change from region to region. So see students, so first one point is reasons of heavy rainfall. Second one is reasons of medium rainfall. Third one is reasons of low rainfall. Fourth one is desert regions. Fifth one is marshy regions. Sixth one is mountainous region. And seventh one is plain. Okay, so how the regions are there, that types of houses are built different place. Okay students, so this is your also activity base. Okay students, A1, observe the map and the pictures of houses and compare the following chart. So see students, the numbers are there, serial number, regions are there, type, shape, constructions, building materials, roof and walls. So see students, if plain regions are there, so how they build the houses, flat roof houses are there, and the shape and construction is rectangular, and roof is made up of wood and earth, and wall is stone and earth. Okay students, so this is 5, that means there are total 5 are there reason. So to make any 5 reasons, suppose first one is plain, so second one, suppose reason you are taking the reason of heavy rainfall. So see students, so what types of houses you have built, that is slanted roofed houses, and the shape and construction is rectangular only. Okay, and see, roof is tiles, iron sheets, and wall you can make the stone and bricks. Okay students, third one is reasons of medium rainfall. So what else up, that means you can make the houses, students, slanted roof houses same, and shape and construction is rectangular, students, and roof it will, that means tiles and sticks, and wall will be built, students, stone, bricks and clay. Okay students, fourth one, suppose you are taking that regions of low rainfall and desert regions. So see, so on that place you can build a houses made up of stone and clay, and shape of construction will be rectangular and square, and see, so wood will be leaves, stick, grass, and wall you can make that stone, bricks or clay. Okay students, and suppose fifth one, you are taking that mountainous regions. So houses will be built multi-story houses. Okay students, and shape and construction will be rectangular only, and roof will be tiles, iron sheets or wood, and wall will be stone and bricks. Okay, so this way, these are also, that means you to observe the map and picture the houses and compute a following chart. And second, students, find and note down the reasons why this difference occur in the construction of houses according to the reasons. See students, according to reason wise, different types of houses are built. Okay, so that is also very important. So type of houses, different reasons, and reasons for changes in the construction of houses. Okay students, so you have to do this. That means what types of reasons are there, that types you have to make the construction of houses. Okay, people build houses to suit the climate of their region. So see students, so people are build houses which are suited to that climate of that region. Okay students, and using the natural resources that are available that place, that particular place. Difference in the construction and building materials give rise to the different types of houses. So see students, so that means what types of regions are there, that types of houses are built. For example students, if plain regions are there, so flat roof houses are built. Okay, and the construction shape is rectangular. Okay students, if the region is heavy rainfall, that means which place heavy rainfalls are happening, students, that place slanted roof houses are built, and the shape and construction also rectangular. And if there is a, that means medium rainfall, student, that place also slanted roof houses are built, and the shape and construction also rectangular. Or suppose that region is a mountainous region, students, that place houses are, that means types of houses are the multi-storied houses, and the shape and construction also rectangular. So it depends on the different region, different types of houses are built. Okay students, so see students, वाटर फूड क्लोथिंग एंड शेल्टर आर द बेसिक नीड्स ऑफ एवरी ह्यूमन बींग्स यू ऑल नो दैट सो वॉट आवर बेसिक नीड्स आर द स्टूडेंट्स सो आवर बेसिक नीड्स आर वाटर फूड क्लोथिंग एंड शेल्टर ओके स्टूडेंट्स हाउएवर दिस नीड्स आर नॉट फुलफिल्ड इन द केस ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी पर्सन देन द फॉलोइंग सिचुएशन अराइज सो सी स्टूडेंट इफ देयर नीड्स आर नॉट फुलफिल्ड सो देयर इट इज गिवन दैट व्हाट टाइप्स ऑफ सिचुएशन अराइज सो सी स्टूडेंट अराउंड अस वी सी मेनी पीपल्स हु lack shelter that means who didn't have their shelter okay who didn't have the house to live for living purpose okay students they seek shelter at the roadside so you can see that they are sleeping where roadside or on footpath or under a bridge in tumble down buildings in railway or bus station and even on open grounds okay students why this one happens students because they didn't have their own house And many people are forced to be homeless because they have insufficient or no means of livelihood. I say students, so many people are forced to be homeless students. Why students? Because they have insufficient or no means of livelihood. So see the picture. Can you see that? Okay, shelters on a footpath where they are living students on the footpath. So they didn't have their own home. So these types of problems they are facing. Okay, students. A section of our society being homeless in social problems. That is why the government implements many schemes to provide a home to the homeless. So see students, that means our society facing lots of problems. Okay, a section of our society being homeless is social problems, and that is why students government implements many schemes to provide homes to the homeless. In some of the cities, the government make night shelter available to the homeless. Okay, students. Why people become homeless? So see students, see the diagram. All these other reasons are there. Why people become homeless? That is lack of affordable housing, inadequate income. Okay, their income will be less. Unemployment problem. They didn't have the job. Physical and mental disorder, natural disasters, poverty problems. So all other reasons are there, students. Why people become homeless? Okay. We all have a right to clean, potable water, sufficient food, and a safe shelter and education. So we all have a right to clean. Okay, students. That means to clean, potable water, sufficient food, and safe shelter and education. Okay, students. Now, see, students. What's the solution? Totally cancel. I mark with pencil. No need to read this or do this. Okay. Do you know that you also can totally cancel students are marked with pencil no need to read this okay now try this see students visit a place where construction work is going on list the material that you see there obtain information about the pollution in that area so this is totally activity based students so you have to do this so two examples are given here that is if materials cement materials are there the original source is limestone if glass will be there material The original source is sand. So you have to find out that it is totally activity based. Okay, students. See the picture. Visit to a construction site. Okay, students. That means you have to observe that and write here in this table. Compare your own list with your friend list. Find the original source and from which construction material is obtained and note them down in the above chart. So it is totally observation based. Okay, students. Always remember totally cancel students no need to read this okay students use these pictures to discuss how environmental pollution affect us so see the picture students first one is see the ship why it was used that a launch extracting sand that means sand that was used to remove the sand from the sea or river beds okay next one is forest fire and because of this fire what happens students air pollution problems are facing okay We can face the air pollution problems, okay? And say that felling trees and forests. What that man is doing? He was cutting the trees, and this way we have faced the what problems? That means if tree will be not there, from where we are getting the proper air? Okay, students. So this way, felling trees and forests. That man is doing the he was cutting the trees and forest. Okay, students. So this way, if tree will be not there, from where we are getting the proper air, fresh air, and because of that. There will be deforestation problems. Afterwards, square inquiry means see that querying 2 minutes to dig stone and sand from a quarry. So because of this, what happened the students? Noise pollution, air pollution. Okay. And last one is drawing excess water. So all these are the, because of that, we can face the lots of different types of environmental pollution. Okay, it will affect us. Okay, students. The population of the world is increasing all the time. That is why houses are being built in large numbers. Natural resources have to be used in very great quantities to build these houses. They are obtained using the method listed below. These methods are harmful to the environment and lead to the pollution of air, water and soil, and also cause noise pollution. So see students, you all know that day by day our population was increasing very large scale, okay? And because of that, houses are being built in a large number, it means very large number. And see students, natural resources have to be used in a very great quantities to build these houses. And see students, they are often using the method listed below, okay? So this method are harmful to the environment and lead to the pollution of air. What is pollution we are facing, students? Air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, and also it causes the noise pollution. So points are given here, students. First point is digging up hills for quarrying. And see students, if you are digging the hills, then what happens? That means quarrying means what, students? To dig stone and sand from a quarry. So because of that, what happened? That noise pollution, air pollution. Because which place we are digging, lots of noise is coming. Okay. Second one is extracting sand from the sea source and river beds. So see the picture, students. A launch extracting sand. So I see that ship was there. In this case, what happened, students? That means extracting sand from the sea source and the river beds. The sand is removed from the sea or river beds. Okay, students. From the rivers or sea. Afterwards, third point is extracting stone and earth from the ground. Okay. And fourth one is drying out excessive amount of groundwater. See the picture. Drying out excessive, that is water removed from that. That means drying out excessive amount of groundwater. And afterwards, see the next point. Fifth point, it is felling tree to clear land. So this is what that man is doing, the students. So he is cutting the trees. And this way, students, felling trees to clear the land. And tree was, that means forest become deforestation. The tree was cut, okay? And last one, filling up pond, lake, streams, river, creek, and low-lying areas to reclaim land. So all these other reasons are there, students. Because of growing urbanization, land which was previously being used for agriculture and similar other purpose is now being used to build road and to raise settlements. So see students, previous whatever land we are using for agriculture or other purpose, nowadays because of the growing urbanization, what happened, that land was whatever used for agriculture previously and similar other purpose, now it was used to build roads and to raise settlements, okay, for living purpose. When this led to a shortage of agriculture land, forest land, and because of that, students, what happened, that now what happened, that when this led to shortage of agricultural land and forest land is used for agriculture, okay? So trees are felled in a great numbers and forests are reduced, and because of that, trees are cut out, and this is what happened, that forests become less and less. That means deforestation problems are facing. Energy is needed to produce construction material. It is used to on a very large scale to prepare brick from soil, cement from limestone, and glass from sand, and so on. And see students, that means energy is needed to produce construction material, okay? So it is used on a very large scale to prepare brick from soil. From where they make prepare the brick from the soil and cement from limestones and glass from sand and so on. So see students, where does the energy come from? It is produced using natural fuels like coal, natural gas, and or mineral oil. These natural fuels can be used only once, and you all know that. These natural fuels can be used only once. They get consumed when we use them. Moreover, burning these fuels lead to air pollution. And see, so that we burning these fuels, what happened, that? So it leads air pollution problems. It takes lack of years for this source of energy to form in nature. And see, students. So see that how much time it takes, that it takes lack of years, okay, for these sources of energy to form in nature. Okay, that is why it is necessary to bring into use other source of energy such as सोलर एनर्जी और विंड एनर्जी विच आर अवेलेबल इन प्लेंटी एंड विच डू नॉट कॉजेस पोल्यूशन। ऐसे व्हाट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स आर देयर, यू ऑल नो दैट। दैट मीन्स इट टेक लैक्स ऑफ ईयर्स फॉर दिस सोर्सेज ऑफ एनर्जी टू फॉर्म इन नेचर। ओके, सो दैट इज वाई इट इज नेसेसरी टू ब्रिंग इन टू यूज ऑफ अदर सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी। सो विच आर द अदर सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी आर देयर, दैट इज एग्जाम्पल सोलर एनर्जी और विंड एनर्जी। सो ऑल दिस एनर्जी विल बी अवेलेबल प्लेंटी एंड विच डू नॉट कॉज एनी पोल्यूशन प्रॉब्लम्स। ओके, एंड दिस आर नॉन एग्जॉस्टेबल सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी। ऐसे स्टूडेंट दिस आर ऑल नॉन एग्जॉस्टेबल सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी। ऑल लिविंग थिंग्स नीड शेल्टर, यू ऑल नो दैट ऑल लिविंग थिंग्स आर नीड शेल्टर। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, लाइक ह्यूमन सम अदर लिविंग थिंग्स ऑल्सो बिल्ड शेल्टर्स यूजिंग वेरियस मटेरियल इन देयर एनवायरमेंट, बट लास्ट ईयर्स वी सॉ दैट देयर शेल्टर्स आर इको फ्रेंडली एंड टेम्पररी। And see, students, you all know that all living things need shelter. Okay, like humans, some other living things also build shelter. Okay, using various materials in this environment, in their environment. But last year we saw that their shelters are eco-friendly and temporary. We should also be able to make permanent house that are eco-friendly. So what we have to do, that students, we should also be able to make permanent houses and that are eco-friendly. Okay, students. Hey students, this is a picture of an eco-friendly house. Okay, see the characteristics. Some characteristics of eco-friendly houses means some features. First point, minimum consumption of natural resources. That means in this minimum consumption of natural resources use. Second point, use of non-exhaustible source of energy such as biogas, wind energy, and solar energy. And see students. In this use of non-exhaustible source of energy, such as what are examples are given here? Biogas, wind energy, and solar energy. Third point, recycling of water. Okay. Fourth point, recycling of garbage. We can again recycle the garbage. That means recycling of garbage, or we can also recycling of water. And that means fifth point is avoiding artificial materials and artificial colors. We will avoid that artificial materials and artificial colors. And last point is provisions of natural light and ventilation in the house. As students, provisions for natural lights and ventilation in the house. See the picture. This picture is an eco-friendly house. Okay, students. And all these are the their features or characteristics of eco-friendly houses. Okay, students. Do you know totally cancel mark with pencil? Do you know that is also totally cancelled? That is a group of seven islands, Mumbai city, Brihan Mumbai metropolis. That is also totally cancelled. Mark with pencil. Okay, students, no need to read this. What we have learned, students, in this chapter 11. Okay, so first point, we observe a variety in the types of house construction in the region of different climate. Okay, second point, houses are built to suit the climate of that region. And third point, see that different material all obtained from nature are used to build house. Then what are the material we are using? All obtained from the nature are used to build houses. Next one is fourth point is we should be judicious in using energy. Okay, that means use proper way, not to waste that. And fifth one is it is necessary to increase the use of non-exhaustible source of energy. Okay, students. And sixth one, it is necessary to build eco-friendly houses. It is very, very important, very, very necessary. And last one is we must take care that the environment is not harmed. So always you have to remember that. So we must take care that environment should not be harmed. Okay, students. All these points we will discuss in this chapter. That is already we have learned in this chapter. Okay, students. Use your brain power. Totally cancel our mark with pencil. What's the solution? That is also totally cancel our mark with pencil. Exercise. Question number 1A. Which of the following houses would be suitable in the mountainous region? Put a right tick mark in the appropriate box. Give a reason for selecting that house. B1. What material will you mainly use for building a multi-storied house? Choose the correct option. Second question, arrange the following consideration from the most to least important in house building. And question number 3, write the following. So see students, all these are the assignment I am giving to you as your homework. So you have to write this in your notebook or in your workbook and read this lesson twice, two times properly. I hope that you understood this lesson. Thank you.